Hello friends, welcome to our YouTube channel ShareGuru Weekly. So today in this video we are going to discuss how the Indian share markets are going to be in the next week, that is starting from 27th August 2018. So cautious. In previous truncated trading week of 4 trading days between 20th August to 24th August 2018, during first 3 days markets have moved forward, and on last trading day on Friday, that is 24th August 2018, BSE Sensex has receded by 85 points and closed at 38,251 points. NSE Nifty has receded by 25.65 points and closed at 11,557 points. For last five sequential weeks, markets have ended at weekly highs. Investors are inclining towards the idea of booking profits and becoming cautious in the market since indices have scaled up lifetime highs during last 5 weeks. INR depreciating to rupees 70.24. Investors are worrying for increase in current account deficit. There is a stalemate in China-America trade war talks. Crude oil rates are inching upwards. Futures and option contracts are closing on Thursday, 30th August 2018, and rollover issues are going to be some of the reasons for the market slowing down in this week. Domestic institutions as well as foreign institutional investors are encashing the situation into a buying opportunity. Watching for this, on Thursday, 23rd August 2018, domestic financial institutions have made net purchase of 142 crores and foreign institutional investors made net purchases to the extent of rupees 433.21 crores. In America-China trade talks, both countries are adamant and stubborn and not coming forward to solve the impasse. Earlier, America has levied import duties on $34 billion worth of Chinese imports and now further extended to additional imports of worth $16 billion. America is preparing itself to levy further import duties on $200 billion worth of goods and services of China by the end of September 2018 month. As a retaliatory measure, China has levied additional import duties on $16 billion worth of goods and services coming from America. Apart from this, China is going to raise this issue with World Trade Organization. This deadlock is going to continue until next trade talks. In this current situation, India is going to be benefited particularly in the fields of textiles, auto components, specialty chemicals, steel and dairy products. Until now, during 2018, INR has depreciated by 9% and made Indian goods more competitive internationally. Due to the depreciation of the INR, imports are becoming expensive, and indirectly it has given protective shield to domestic manufacturers. In July 2018, exports of garments and fabrics increased by 11% on month-on-month basis than the previous July 2017. Export of textiles and garments in July 2017 are 17,692 crores, are increased to rupees 19,636 crores in July 2018. During the last year, textile exports have increased by 7%, whereas imports are standing still at earlier year levels only. All the integrated textile mills with garment manufacturing capacities are going to declare good Q2 FY19 results. All the Indian automobile companies are manufacturing vehicles over and above the established capacities. These companies are unable to meet the domestic demand for vehicles arising out of forthcoming festive season are diverting exporting quota to domestic markets. It is really a festive mood to celebrate festive bonanza for all Indian automobile and automotive components companies. In vehicles, up to 40% of total weight steel is being used. Along with auto companies, steel companies are going to earn good profits. According to World Steel Association, the demand is going to increase by 5.5% in 2018 and by 6% in 2019 in India. Indian steel consumption is increasing very fast in world's top 10 steel consuming countries. Dairy companies are declaring good profits. L&T is going to buy back up to 6 crore shares at 1500 rupees per share. At present, it is trading at rupees 1342. And there is an opportunity that it may further move forward to rupees 1700 over a period of time. Depending upon the buyback acceptance ratio, one can make good yield in short span. Market makers are showing much interest in Mohata Industries Limited share. Prabhat Dairy Limited, Parag Milk Food Limited have declared excellent Q1 FY19 results. Internationally, supply shortage is taking place for bulk drug ibuprofen. IOL Chemicals and Pharmaceuticals Limited has increased its production capacity of ibuprofen from 7,200 tons to 10,000 tons, and it is going to be a windfall wealth for the company. Kennametal India Limited in June 2017 quarter has earned 2.15 crores net profit, and in June 2018 it has earned 20.73 crores net profit. Up to the closing of F&O contracts, markets may slow down, and once it is over, markets may move forward further. This is an excerpt from our magazine Share Guru Weekly editorial for the coming next week, 27th August to 2nd September 2018. Signing off, yours Radhakrishna from Team Share Guru Weekly. Thank you. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel Share Guru Weekly for more updates and exciting opportunities in Indian share markets. Thank you.